H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
So, do you guys know about like verification and validation? Do you want to like, can we discuss about that topic? Because like,
sure. About Agile Scrum, which is now into market.
Because
everybody is learning about Agile Scrum. No more traditional modules.
Yeah, right now in every company, I think they follow the Agile model. So it is good to know about it.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah, go ahead, Praveena.
I have a question. What happens when a bug found in the production environment? Do you have any idea about that?
Yeah, that's, I feel that that is a defect with the development team because they are the ones who does the coding part. So that should be reported to the development team and DA and PM. Because we as the testers, we do only test cases and RTM. We are not involved in that part. We are done as a tester, but it mainly depends on coding and it all depends on the higher level of not testers.
Actually, after it moves into production, the functional testing team or the functional development team will not come into picture, right? So it is just still the user acceptance testing. We all will be involved. So as soon as it moves into production, it's just a completely different ball game where you have the project support, like whatever term you call them, there's a project support team which takes care of any like live bug which comes. If a project is gone live and whatever happens, then the project support team will take care of that. So not the functional developer and the tester will never come into picture. To answer your question, was it Praveena who asked that?
So do you know, do you guys, anybody know like first developer developed software and then the build would be put in the like testers environment, and then after we test like that build, where does that go, like in the production, or if everything is good, then like what would be the next in software life cycle? Hello.
Yeah, like initially you'll have the development environment, right? So development environment is exclusively for development, and you have the server database for that environment, and you'll create the code, and then you'll move it to the testing environment where the testers will come in and they'll start testing. Then you have something called a staging environment, where the SIT environment, which is called the system integration environment, where like all the modules are integrated, not only the application level, even the like server and the database level, all the modules will be integrated. Then you have the user acceptance testing. So that will be a separate environment. After that, after if you have like no beta testing, and if the beta testing is like for live application, if for say like no Gmail application is there, and you release a beta version of it, then it will go live into production.
Okay.
So at that time, you'll put it into production. If it is not a beta version and you're just doing the alpha part of the user acceptance testing, then still it will remain in the UAT environment. It will not go to the production.
Okay.
So after this is completed, after the user acceptance testing is completed, it will be deployed. So deployment is the real production part. And don't get confused with all the terminologies, like, no, you can, it is not necessary you should have a separate development environment or testing environment. It can be both the same. It depends on company to company, and you will have different environments.
Okay.
I have a question. Normally, when you are using a quality center in your project, so are we going to prepare RPM? If yes, what is the purpose there, preparing of RPM there? Because RPM is to map, to know the test coverage, right? Already we are doing it in quality center. So is it necessary? And do we really do RTM?
Actually, you can do RTM in Excel sheet or quality center, like anywhere you can do it. Wherever you feel comfortable, you can do it.
Actually, that is true. Like, if you are doing your test cases in Excel, then you can maintain your RTM in Excel as well. But if you're doing everything in QC, then you will be able to link your requirements and test cases, right? So you'll be able to trace back whatever test cases you've written with the requirements. So I don't think you need a separate RTM in Excel.
In Excel sheet, we can see like all steps at a time, but in QC, like you make one test case and test step, and then you make another test case and test step. So if you initially make in Excel document, that would be easy to view, like all the steps and identify all those. So I guess first, if we make in Excel and then we import it to the QC, that would be easier way.
Yeah, but it is totally depend on what is the procedure of the company. If we will be asked to create a RTM in Excel, if we are using QC and we will be asked to create a RTM in Excel, we need to create it. It depend on the process of company. If your lead tell say you to create it, you have to.
Okay.
Even I heard like they will prepare RTM in Excel even though they are using QC. That's why I got it out.
Yes.
So thank you, Dinesh.
They use the Excel for RTM.
Okay, and I have a question related to this. Do we always create RTM after test cases, or it be optimizations? Remember, but one of the instructors, they like when writing test cases, he wrote in one of the columns requirement ID, and he said we don't need RTM.
No, in
so
the
okay. First question: how you will create RTM? You take one module, account module. You have requirement. How will you create RTM?
Yeah, first I have to create test cases, and then I will create RTM.
Yes. Test cases and then
okay. You will. This is your way. How I will create? No. I am explaining that. Suppose I have one module's requirement, account requirement, right? So what I will create column in Excel sheet, requirement number so and description, right? All the requirement I will attach in. Insert in Excel sheet. Then I will create test cases. Maybe one requirements one requirement have more than one test case,
right.
Or by one test case include more than one requirement, one to many or many to one issue ratio, right? Then I will assign, I have another column, test case number and test case description. Suppose requirement one, I have test case number 1, 5, and 7 related with, I will assign those three number in that test case number, test case ID and description.
Right, right.
Same way, suppose my disk is one is also related with the requirement number 5, I will assign that 2 also in that with that requirement number 5 and test case number 1. I link those test case with two requirements. So first I insert all the requirement in my Excel sheet, then I will create the test cases based on the requirement, and I link those test cases with the requirement. This is my way. There are a number of ways.
I have a question for you. Like, you mean when we do the login part, we do valid, invalid, blank, and also with the test cases, then you tally with both, you mean?
I didn't get you there. So,
for example, like login, let's take login. Mm-hmm. We do write for valid, invalid, blank, right? For test cases, we do for 3, mm-hmm. valid, invalid, and blank. So in test cases also, we do the same.
Yeah, so you can, if you are creating all the test cases based on the one requirement, that you have to assign all these things, those test cases one with the one requirement. If you created 10 or 15 or 25 test cases based on one requirement, it doesn't matter. You have to assign all test cases with those requirements.
Got it, Dinesh. Thank you.
Yeah, requirement requirement will like that, like login functionality. So you have to check login functionality with the username, enter username, enter password, enter valid username, enter invalid username and password.
Like, so you suppose what is your requirement? Okay, you should be able to with the valid credential. Then they will also, you have the sub requirement or other requirement. These special characters are allowed. This is the length, username and password. So you have to assign this test case with all the requirements.
Yeah. So the requirement is just like that, like login functionality. So you have to first make a RTM. So you have to make a RTM and think about like what kind of test cases, what kind of requirement.
Yeah, but requirement login functionality, they will mention everything in the detail.
Mm-hmm.
What is valid and what is invalid? If you don't know what is valid and what is invalid, then how you will create the data? How you will create the invalid test cases?
Mm-hmm. I think they might be mentioned in the requirement only.
Yeah. So you will have all those information, and it's very simple.
So I guess, yeah, first you have to make RTM and then depend on it, you make test cases. Because if you don't know requirement, then how can you make the test cases?
Yeah, very simple.
Yes, Sheetal, like, no, I agree with whatever Dinesh said. It is just that in the classes, whatever we were taught, we prepared initially the RTM. But if you had seen, there were requirements are the ones which we filled out, but we didn't fill the side part, which was the test cases. So we have to write the requirements first. Then after writing the test cases, we need to map the test cases with the requirements. It is just to make sure that you're not missing out on any requirements.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
So that is the way, I think that is the perfect way to do it. Like first write down RTM, first understand the requirements and then write down RTM, find out test data and everything, and then try to write down test cases, depend on it. And test step and everything, and then you execute it, and then you find out the results.
Yeah, you will have n number of requirements, right? You have to make sure you have covered all the requirements in test cases. So to make sure that only, we are mapping the test cases back to the requirements.
Yeah, that's the way we can figure out. Like,
first RTM and then test cases, right?
I'm sorry?
You said we have to write the RTMs and then test cases. That is what we were doing before, and now we came to know like,
what I was telling was, in the classes we used to prepare the requirement traceability matrix, which had two columns, like one was for the requirements and one was for the test cases. So the requirements were the ones which we filled out, but we didn't fill out the test cases part. So after you write the test cases, you have to come back and map each and every requirement to the test cases.
Yeah.
Okay, got
it. So that's why remember that we prepared requirement traceability matrix first. But generally, what we do is we prepare the requirement template first, then the test cases, then map the test cases with the requirements. That's called the RTM.
Okay, okay. Thank you. RTM. What is traceability matrix? Can anybody tell what is traceability matrix? Mapping between test cases and requirements. I'm sorry, I didn't hear properly. That is the mapping between requirements and test cases, RTM.
RTM is a requirement traceability matrix where we list all the requirements that are to be tested.
Yes.
So
requirement traceability matrix is a list of requirements that need to be tested. Is that the answer?
Sheetal, like RTM is something where you can go and check whether all your requirements are covered in test cases. So initially you have the requirements like a separate thing, then from the requirements you tend to write the test cases, right?
Yeah.
So you have to map the test cases back to the requirement, whether every requirement has one test case pertaining to that. So for that you create a common template called requirement traceability matrix. Okay. Where you will put your requirements and you will put the corresponding test cases on the side.
Okay. So we can say like mapping the requirement to the test cases, it's called the traceability matrix.
Yeah, for the coverage of requirements and test cases, or for mapping the test cases back to the requirements.
Okay.
My question is, do we always have to use Excel sheet for RTM, or is there any provision in QC also to make a requirement traceability matrix?
I couldn't hear you properly. Can you is your question again?
My question is, do we already have to use Excel for making RTM, or is there any provision in QC also to make RTM in which we can directly or automatically trace the, there is always some test code for all test cases, and there is always some functionality, function requirement code for, Excel requirement.
Test plan, I think you can make those things, like in test plan module, in quality center.
You have the requirement coverage part, right?
But not for requirements.
No, you will be able to do both from requirements and from the test plan module. So in requirements, if you just go see the requirement details, you will have something called a coverage tab. So from there, you will be able to connect your test cases and requirements. From the test plan module, you will be able to do that using the requirement coverage tab. So you will be able to do both vice versa.
I wasn't talking about test plan in QC. I was talking about test plan documents.
Okay, okay. Yeah, got it.
I have a question here. Do you all see the screen? I see only that lady, H2K impulses. I don't see any of the screen. Is it the way it is today?
Even we are seeing the same thing. It is a white screen right now.
Yeah, I see that lady. I don't know who you see, but it is on H2K probably. I don't know, but I was wondering. I don't see the question. So, okay, thank you.
Is the next question?
Did anybody got an interview or anything like any question from interviewer?
Hello.
Yeah.
I have a question. I want to know, like, how do we write the requirements and the test cases in real? Like, first, do we create everything in Excel and then we go to the quality center and write back everything, or we do it directly? Like, how do we do requirement and how do we do the test cases? Everything is in Excel first, is it? Like, I want to know.
I think I asked that question to Priya and the instructor, and she told me like you can do either way. Like, if you like, you can make on Excel sheet and copy and paste to quality center. Or if you are comfortable with quality center, you can directly enter it to end.
Not exactly. If you have quality center and your lead will ask you to create test cases in quality center, then you can't create in Excel because the counting time, they will not give you extra time.
Yeah, that is true.
Yeah, if they say you, okay, first you create in Excel, then we will export all the test cases in quality center, from Excel to quality center, then you can write it.
Mm-hmm.
But if they, you will be asked to create in quality center, you have to create in quality center.
Mm-hmm.
If they ask you create in Excel, you have to create in Excel.
Okay.
No choice.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
No, I have a question here. Do they hire us for quality center separately, or the manual testing have to do writing test cases as well as quality center? Is that the way it is, or separate jobs?
No. As a tester, we have to write, and it's easy. If you can write in Excel, you can write in a quality center.
Yeah, thanks, Dinesh.
Yeah, I know, but the thing is, they are hired differently or the same job?
No, same job. All the quality center also, it's easy.
Yeah. Okay.
There are some tabs where you have to provide the information. There are some predefined. So you have to select only those things, and you have to write the detail. Suppose why you are creating in detail time, why you are creating these test cases. Verify the login functionality with the valid user ID and password. And which data, test data, which URL use. Provide that, then go at the step. Click, it will display the steps. Enter there, enter, open the browser and enter URL. What is your expected result? Right there. That's it. It's so simple.
Thank you, Dinesh.
Dinesh, 1 second. Does anybody has a real experience in working in any company or anything? If they want to share their experience, that would be really great. Hello?
Do you hear me?
Yeah, can you?
Yeah, I have a question about RTM and the quality center, the Excel sheet. Where we will write the test cases and the requirement? Directly we can write it in the quality center, right?
Yeah, we can directly write on quality center.
Okay. So they'll follow, each organization follow the different things. They will go through the Excel sheet or the quality center, like the way it works, or they'll do both?
I think Dinesh was telling, like, whatever the lead tell you, you have to follow those things only.
So, okay, we got the instruction where we can do that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, thank you.
I was talking, like, anybody did work in the company, like, if they want to share their experience in real work class. Like,
how long is the class?
I'm sorry?
How long is the class?
How long this
GD
discussion?
Uh-huh.
It is about 2 hours, so it started 12:30, so maybe one more hour.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah, Sheetal, I joined lately. Can I know what happened in the first 1 hour of about 45 minutes? Anything important?
No, just this kind of discussion only, right? So everybody's talking like with their own ideas.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. So anybody has a real experience in working like any company or with anything related to testing?
Sheetal?
Yeah.
I have a doubt regarding the morning session, the case, use cases and the activity cases. If anybody like to share or explain about those things, is it good for me?
About what?
Morning in the CRM project session.
Uh-huh.
So I didn't focus on that. So I need some help to get the ideas from people.
Yeah. Tell me if I know anything. I can tell you about it.
They discussed about the cases, test case and the activity cases, how it really works on the CRM project.
Today we have to make a test case. Even I also have to make those test cases.
So can you talk about it, about the use cases in the CRM project and the activities little bit? About the user case and the activity case.
So did you attend today's class?
Yeah, I attend, but I didn't go through the thing, so I'm not sure. I can't talk. I don't know fully, so I don't.
Actually, he talk about a little bit about Scrum. In a Scrum meeting, what we do, how should we talk, whatever we did yesterday and what we are going to do today. So we just have to talk about in very short statement, I finished this task yesterday and today I'm planning to do this kind of task.
Mm-hmm.
That's all. For a Scrum meeting, we just talk. All person are standing and they talk short, just a brief idea about their work.
Mm-hmm.
And then
about we spoke about three architecture, about CRM and how it works, and everybody got a chance to talk about each topic for about a minute or so, and we just have to, for tomorrow he told us to prepare some test cases and find some bugs. And again, tomorrow as a Scrum, we have to talk about today, what topics we spoke about in the morning, and add up saying that today we are going to talk about test cases and issues. And then later on, as and when Sam says, we have to share the screen.
Yeah, JC, I need about the activity case and the use case, those things. I need some information, some ideas about. Can you guys talk about the CRM use case and activity?
Even first hour, I was not there. I had my doctor's appointment, so I was also waiting for somebody to talk about that.
So, yeah, I didn't go through the thing. I didn't do the workout, so that's neither me.
Yeah. Today, I thought I'll do whole homework so that I'll be more easy to talk.
Okay. Thank you.
Welcome.
Yeah, it's just about everybody was talking about.
Is there recording of morning session?
Morning session and yesterday session, CRM.
Did they send recording also? Because I have not attended it.
It is a live project session that is going on. Today it was second day, and tomorrow I think it is last day.
It was only for 2 days, since it's going a little slow, I guess. That's what they extended to third day, and we got the link for tomorrow also. The old link doesn't work, so we got the link. I just kept on my email about they're continuing another 2 hours from 8 to 10.
They didn't send any PowerPoint material or videos, recorded videos, right?
Sam said he will send the notes, but they haven't recorded the class, I guess. I also wanted the recording, so they said they haven't recorded.
Mm-hmm. Hello?
Yes. Yeah, can you please share the assignment for tomorrow? What Sam has told us?
Yeah, it is write down the test cases for component test cases.
Uh-huh.
For any module.
Oh, okay. And, then
he also tell to check if you log in with one user ID and you make one test you make one case on open test and a new case and you log out from that login ID and you log in with another login ID.
Mm-hmm.
You have to check like whatever you made the case on the previous ID, it is showing on that or not.
Okay.